Today we're going to talk about the Endstop for the RADDS board, and I want to go through a couple of things real quick. We have our X-min Endstop here, our Y-min Endstop here, and our Z-min. Then we have our X-max, our Y-max, and our Z-max. Now the pins work as follows. We have our 3.3 volt power, we have our ground, and then we have our signal pin. And that's true for the whole row down for 3.3, as well as ground, and then signal. So in a moment, I'll show you the Endstop and how to connect it. This is our Endstop. It's a switch Endstop that works by toggling a switch when it reaches something. So on here, I've marked in colors red for power, black for ground, and blue for signal. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it. But first, let me show you the wire that we're going to use to connect to it. This has the wires of red, then it has black in the center, and then it has green on the outside, which is used for signal. So to connect it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide the connector in and attach it. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the RADDS board. Okay, to connect it to the board, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to connect to X-max, so you can see how that works. It's the pin that's fourth from the top over here. And I've connected red on the outside for power, black in the center for ground, and green on the right for signal. Now keep in mind that this is 3.3 volts. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the firmware after I show you how to connect the USB serial cable. Okay, before we can connect the firmware to the board, we have to connect the serial cable to communicate. So what we're going to do is we're going to connect the small side to the port closest to the power on the Arduino Due board. And we're going to connect the other side to the computer, and you'll hear a beep. Now keep in mind, you don't want to touch this area once it's been energized. In a moment, I'll show you how to load the firmware. Okay, in order to do this, we have a new firmware called Marlin. It says -bugfix-2.0.x. This is an experimental software. Someday they'll actually have a full release. So I'm going to open up this folder. I'm going to go to the Marlin folder. I'm going to go to the marlin.ino. But before I do that, I want to show you something over here. Under the Marlin folder, we want to go to the source folder, and we want to go to the core folder. Inside the core, there's a boards.h. We're going to open that up, and we're going to do a search on RADDS. And this is what our board name will be. It's board_RADDS. So we're going to copy that. We're going to close out of this. We're going to go back to the folder where the marlin.ino is. We're going to open that up. Okay, now that we're in the folder, there's only three tabs. There's a Marlin tab, there's a config.h tab, and there's a config.advanced tab. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the config.h. We're going to do a search on mother. And what we have here is motherboard. And then it has a default of board_ramps_14_EFB. We're going to change that to board_RADDS. Now, we're also connected to the ZMAX, so we got to find the Endstop. So we're going to do a search on Endstop. and we're going to scroll down and read through this real quick. Right now we have use xmin underscore plug all the way to use zmin underscore plug. Now what that means is that these are currently the default configurations that are enabled. But seeing how we're on the use underscore xmax plug that we're using for xmax, we have to uncomment this. So we're going to uncomment it. Now the next thing we need to do is, because the logic is inverted for the end stop, it's not going to read correctly. So what we want to do is we want to change inverting for xmax to true. This will leave it as open as if it's not been reached. So in a moment, I'm going to upload the firmware, but before I do that, I'm going to check to see that we have the Arduino Due programming port selected. And then I'm also going to make sure that we have COM3 selected for the serial USB. And now I'm going to compile and upload over here. In a moment, I'll show you how to test it in Pronterface. Okay, now we're going to test it. So we have to open up Pronterface. Now that Pronterface is open, we need to connect to the device. And we're going to type M119 and then enter. And what we're going to see is that the XMAX says open because we inverted the logic. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to actuate the sensor with our finger. And as you can see, a little light came on. And we're going to press send for M119 again. And now it says triggered. So if you release it, and you press send again, it says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.